You are now listening to Countdown to Kickoff, presented by DolphinsTalk.com. To get you ready for today's game, here's your host, Tom Ernisse.
Hello, Dolphins fans, and thank you for listening to Countdown to Kickoff, presented by DolphinsTalk.com. I am your host, Tom Ernisse, getting you ready for the Week 7 primetime Sunday Night Football matchup for your Miami Dolphins traveling to Philadelphia to take on the Eagles. Kickoff is at 8:25 p.m. Weather 44 degrees, and it looks like it's going to be a bit breezy for the game. Before we dive into all of this, I want to give a big shout out to everyone listening over at finheaven.com, the largest Miami Dolphins message board on the internet, as well as everyone over at the Facebook group, I Am a Miami Dolphins Fan, run by the great Carlos Hernandez, and all of you who are subscribed to our podcast network, whether that's on Apple, Podbean, Stitcher, Google Play, wherever it is you are listening to us, a big thank you for doing so. And we're going to get right into it. So, usually like to start these off with, what happens if the Dolphins get a win from a history perspective? Well, this will be the first 6-1 start since 1999. Also, it'll be the second win on Sunday Night Football in the same season, and the first time this has happened since 2003. This would be the 10th win over the Philadelphia Eagles in the all-time series. Miami is currently 9-6 against the team, and this would be a third straight win over an NFC East opponent. Their last two wins against the NFC East, both against the Giants, one in 2021, and of course in October in South Florida, where they beat the Giants pretty soundly. So let's get into the injury report for both teams. We'll start with the Philadelphia Eagles. Reed Blankenship, starting safety, and starting slot corner Bradley Roby, both did not practice all week. They are out. The list of players that were on their injury report have no game time statuses. Jalen Carter, Dallas Goedert, Devonta Smith, Sidney Brown, Lane Johnson, Eli Ricks, Darius Slay, Marlon Tupulu, and Milton Williams all had some form of a limited practice or full practice this week and have no game designations. For your Miami Dolphins, we know Jalen Ramsey. He is on the injury report for the first time all season. He was limited all week. He is listed as out. The Dolphins will not be bringing him back this week. Xavien Howard, Alec Ingold, Nick Needham, and Connor Williams all listed questionable. Chase Claypool is on here with a knee injury. He was a full participant in practice. Kader Kohu also with a neck injury that he sustained last week. He is a full go. Jalen Phillips, Andrew Van Ginkel, and running back Jeff Wilson Jr., all no game statuses. They are good. For everyone, for Philadelphia, minus their two starting secondary players, a corner, safety Reed Blankenship, who is their leading tackler, and Bradley Roby, who was signed a couple weeks ago. They're the only two that are out. Everybody else is ready to go, so the Eagles are coming in fairly healthy. For the Dolphins, they did activate Jeff Wilson Jr. off injured reserve, so Jeff Wilson will be backing up starting running back Raheem Mostert. And they elevated tight end Tanner Connor for the game against the Eagles as well. One name that you will not see this week who was listed questionable was Nick Needham. He was actually downgraded to out on Saturday. So the Dolphins will not activate Nick Needham off injured reserve. And the last chance for Nick Needham to get off injured reserve will be Wednesday the 25th. And if he is not, he will be on injured reserve for the entire season. And to me, it doesn't make much sense. He was a full participant in practice on Friday. So I would expect Nick Needham will be off injured reserve come Wednesday. Team rankings. This is a fun matchup for the Miami Dolphins. This is a very intriguing matchup for the Dolphins, as the Eagles have a pretty potent offense. They're second in the NFL in total offense and yards per game at 395. Their pass offense is ninth with 245 yards per game, and their rush is at 150 yards per game, which is second best in the NFL. The Dolphins' defense come in at 343.7 yards per game, which is 20th. Their pass defense is 19th at 229.2 yards per game, and their rush defense at 114.5. So both the pass and rush defense will get their hands are going to be full. The Eagles are a very sound football team. They did struggle against the Jets. We'll talk about that here shortly. For the Dolphins, they are number one in total offense, pass, and rush at 498.7 yards per game for total offense. Their pass offense is 316.8, and their rush offense at 181.8. Again, all ranked number one. For the Eagles, they are ninth ranked in total defense, giving up only 298 yards per game. They are 20th in pass defense at 232.2 yards per game, and their rush defense is second in the NFL behind the Browns at 65.8 yards per game. In the advantage department, I go through each position group and give you who I believe has the advantage going into this game. So quarterbacks, this is obviously going to be a topic of conversation leading up to kickoff all throughout the game. Tua Tagovailoa versus former Alabama teammate Jalen Hurts. I'm not going to dive into the history between the two. We know the history between the two. In the national championship game, Tua replaced Jalen Hurts. Then Tua gets hurt. Jalen replaces Tua. It's all history. But in regards of an advantage for these teams going into this game in this particular position group, I give the nod slightly to Tua Tagovailoa for the quarterback. I know Tua is playing at an extremely high level this season. And this is a big game for Tua. The reason being it's such a big game for him personally is this is a road game. This is a Super Bowl caliber team in the Eagles. And in Tua's career has not performed well against these types of teams. You know, we can go back to last year and the struggles that he had against the Chargers on Sunday Night Football. The loss to the Bills where he did play well, but again, another loss. The Packers on Christmas. There is a lot for Tua to prove. And at this point, he is the current odds-on favorite for most valuable player, again, very early in the season. And the reason he has the advantage on Jalen Hurts right now is Jalen is struggling. This is not the same Eagles offense that we saw in 2022. Granted, they're still ranked second in the NFL in total offense. But there's struggles. You know, we don't see a lot of the read option from Jalen Hurts in this offense. He is not taking a lot of what the defenses are giving him. He is going for home run shots more consistently and taking more shots down the field. And he has been turning the football over. So, Tua, for me, Tua has the advantage in the quarterback department. Let's go to the running back room. The Eagles will be bringing out DeAndre Swift and Kenneth Gainwell as the top dogs. They also have Boston Scott in the mix. The Dolphins adding back Jeff Wilson Jr. behind Raheem Mostert and Savon Ahmed. I give the nod to the Dolphins. You know, they're the number one rush offense in the NFL at 181.8. They are missing their guy, Devon Achane, who will be back after the bye week. And the Eagles, they're not slouches here in the run game department. I mean, they haven't been using Jalen Hurts' legs as frequently as they did in 2022. But DeAndre Swift is having a career renaissance after the trade from Detroit Kenneth Gainwell has seen less touches since his week one starting position. Boston Scott's a good scat back, but I give the edge to the Dolphins here in this department. Wide receiver room. The Eagles boast two very good wide receivers in A.J. Brown and Devonta Smith. They also have Quez Watkins kind of rounding out the top three. We know the Dolphins have Tyreek Hill, the number one wide receiver currently in the NFL. Jalen Waddle starting to come on over the last couple weeks. And hopefully we see, obviously, Braxton Berrios. And hopefully we see Chase Claypool. Prior to this recording, of course, we do not know the inactives. We'll find that out around 7 o'clock, an hour and a half before kickoff. So I'll be interested to see if Chase Claypool's name is on the inactive list. This would be a great game for him to play in, being the size advantage that he will have and all the attention that's going to be thrown towards Tyreek Hill. But I'm going to give this a push in regards of the wide receiver. Again, Tyreek Hill is the best wide receiver on the football field, hands down. A.J. Brown is no slouch. He has been fantastic over the last few weeks. And Devontae Smith and Jalen Waddle, to me, are a push overall. So I'm going to make this a push in the wide receiver room. Again, no disrespect to our guys here in South Florida, but it's a very strong position group over there. In tight end, Dallas Goedert is a top five tight end, in my opinion, in the NFL, and therefore they have the advantage. Durham Smythe not being used a ton in the pass department. They did Tua did target him in the end zone last week against Carolina, but it was tipped at the line of scrimmage. Goddard's just a difference maker. This is a guy, and we'll get through that as we go through some of the matchups here in the game. Offensive line is not even a question. The Dolphins have been playing very well this year, but they are not anywhere close to the Philadelphia Eagles level on that side of the ball. Jason Kelce is the best center in football. Lane Johnson is the best right tackle in football. In fact, Lane Johnson has not given up a sack since 2020. Crazy. Crazy. Dolphins defense has the work cut out for them. On the defensive line, I give the edge to Philadelphia. Jalen Carter has been an absolute difference maker for the Eagles defense. Obviously, Fletcher Cox is still floating around. They have very good pass rushers. The Dolphins are no slouches there. But they do struggle in the middle of their defensive line. Raekwon Davis is not having a good season. This is an important game for the Dolphins' defensive line. From a linebacking perspective, I give the edge to Miami slightly just because of the players Miami carries in the linebacking group, because they do play a traditional 3-4 versus the Eagles, who play more of like that 4-3 style. I'm liking what I'm seeing from Bradley Chubb, Andrew Van Ginkle. Jalen Phillips is probably going to get a lot more reps this week than he did last week against Carolina as they're easing him back into game action. But Chubb has been very good. He's in the top five in the NFL in pass rush win rate. He made some noise against Carolina. This unit is coming around. Also, David Long Jr. has the highest rush grade per PFF, if you like the analytical side of it. He's number one in the NFL in run defense per Pro Football Focus. Defensive backs, I give to the edge to the Dolphins. I gave it to him because of the thought that Nick Needham was coming back and bolstering that unit. I still give the edge to the Dolphins, Xavier Howard. Darius Slay is really good, but when you go deeper into the secondary, there's nobody on the football field like Javon Holland. Nobody. And they're going to be playing Sidney Brown in his first career start at safety. We'll see how the Dolphins attack that. Special teams, Philadelphia gets the edge here. I still do not trust Jake Bailey with his punts. It seems like his averages are in the low 40s, and as well as Jason Sanders, has been kicking. He's been kicking extra points. And with the conditions that we might be facing with the wind gusts, I trust Jake Elliott a little bit more than Jason Sanders. So they get the edge there. From a coaching perspective, I give this a push. There's no real advantages here. Nick Sirianni is a very sound, offensive-minded head coach. And Mike McDaniel has just been phenomenal for the Dolphins this year. So that gets a push. Before we get into my key matchups for the game, we're going to do a quick ad, of course, talking about men's skincare and Caldera Lab. Guys, it takes less than a few minutes each and every morning and less than a few minutes before you go to bed to use three great products from Caldera Lab to make your face look as young as can be. And if you are young, it can make you look younger. Get you back in your teenage years, I guess. The regimen includes three products. It's the Clean Slate, the Base Layer, and the Good. The Clean Slate starts and ends your day. The face wash leaves your skin all very refreshed. The Base Layer is your daily moisturizer to hydrate your skin, to jumpstart your day full of confidence. And, of course, the Good is the go-to multifunctional serum at night that helps your skin look tighter and smoother, as well as help reduce the visibility of wrinkles and fine lines. Go to calderalab.com, use promo code DolphinsTalk, and get 20% off your order. All right, key matchups for the game. The first one that I have circled on here, and this is the game wrecker. If the Dolphins can't get this figured out, but we do not know the current status of Connor Williams. It seems the Dolphins are leaning towards starting Liam Eichenberg in this game against the Eagles, but Connor Williams is questionable. Mike McDaniel said throughout the week that he is moving better, he's looking better. But again, it's a long season. It is a soft tissue injury with his groin. They are going to be cautious. So the first key matchup is either Liam Eichenberg or Connor Williams versus Jalen Carter. You know, Miami is going to want to run the ball. This is a game, I think, where both teams want to run the ball. Neither team defense wants to be on the field very long against the opposing offense. The Dolphins have to establish a ground game. They have to keep Tua Tagovailoa upright. And whoever's playing at center, whether it's Eichenberg or Williams, they have to keep Jalen Carter out of the backfield. Carter can be an absolute game wrecker, and I still don't understand how this guy fell to the Eagles at 9 in the draft. It's just unfair. It was unfair. Second key matchup is Darius Slay versus Tyreek Hill. These guys have gone back and forth on social media a little bit. This is a huge game. Darius Slay is coming back from his injury, and his first task is to go against Tyreek Hill. Again, Slay is on the wrong side of 30, I believe. He's coming off a knee injury, and he's got to go against the Cheetah. So this is a huge matchup, and if the Tyreek Hill can win those matchups against Darius Slay, the Miami Dolphins offense is going to be humming against his defense. My keys to victory for this game: number one is running the football. You have the number one ranked rush offense, 181.8 yards per game. Raheem Mostert has virtually at times looked unstoppable. He's averaging over 5-plus yards a carry. He actually is the current NFL record holder for yards per carry by a running back, as he surpassed Bo Jackson last week for his game against Carolina. And if this weather is potentially going to be what it's going to be with the winds, we're not going to see a ton of downfield throws. A lot of this is going to be played 20 yards and in from the line of scrimmage, in my opinion. And it's going to rely on Raheem Mostert, Jeff Wilson Jr., and Savant Ahmed to run the football and to be a very effective group running the football. I think they can get it done, but they have to stick to it. Mike McDaniel can't get cute and get away from it. Second key to victory is not letting Jalen Hurts beat you with his legs. Against the Jets last week, they did a great job at the line of scrimmage, making sure they made him uncomfortable and they forced bad decisions because they collapsed the middle of the pocket. They always had somebody readily available to go after Jalen Hurts if he wants to take off with the ball. They forced the turnovers. This guy can absolutely kill your defense on third and long if you just let him run the ball. So there has to be a spy at all times. They have to be very committed to their lanes, their gaps, and not allow Jalen Hurts to beat you with the legs. My third key to victory is do not settle. What do I mean by that? Do not settle. Philly is the most aggressive football team when it comes to going for it on these fourth and shorts because of the very next thing that I will talk about. It kind of goes hand in hand. But they're a very aggressive team. If they're at midfield and it's fourth and four, they go for it. If they're at their own 45-yard line and it's fourth and two, they go for it. The Dolphins have to not settle. They have to go punch for punch with the Eagles. So if the Dolphins have it fourth and short at midfield, don't punt it. Go for it. They have to be aggressive in this game to beat Philadelphia because the opposing coach is going to be aggressive. You have to match it, and you have to pick up these short yarded situations. And the last key to victory is you got to stop this stupid tush push that Philadelphia does. Second and one, third and one, fourth and one, they are going to run this play, and they are so successful at it that they will do it wherever on the football field because they know nobody has been able to stop it. They're the ones that have perfected it. Other teams have tried it. They haven't been successful with it. Dolphins tried something cute with it last week, not doing the tush push, but they decided to throw it backwards to Mostert because everybody was at the line of scrimmage. A brilliant play call, terrible execution in that regards. I wish they would have not done that against Carolina and have that in their back pocket for the game against the Eagles. Those are my keys to victory. Let's get into the prediction. So far, I have picked the Miami Dolphins to win every single game this year. I am 5-1 in my predictions. This is a huge game. This is a nationally televised game. This is a game where the Dolphins can shut the national media up. Opposing fan bases, they can shut up. This is a game against the Eagles. If they go out and win, we'll finally prove the naysayers wrong. The Dolphins haven't played anybody this year. They've played cupcakes or whatever they want to say. You go into Philadelphia and you beat the defending NFC champions on their field with the same equivalent record at 5-1. That's a statement. And I believe the Dolphins will make a statement, and I think they will beat the Eagles. I think they will beat the Eagles 30-28. I think this is going to be a very fun game. It is going to give me agita. hopefully on the post-game wrap-up show with Mike Oliva and myself, we're going to be talking about a win. A Dolphins win to put them to 6-1. And on track to be possibly 7-1 going into the game against the Chiefs in Germany in week 9. But we got to get through this one first. I'd like to thank you all for listening to Countdown to Kickoff. Be sure to follow me on X, formerly known as Twitter, at Dolphins Talk Tom. The main account is at Dolphins Talk on all your social media platforms. And be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel, DolphinsTalk.com Daily. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and also hit the alert bell so when we go live with the post-game wrap-up show, you can jump in the chat Have conversation with other fans of the Miami Dolphins while we break down, hopefully, a victory over the Philadelphia Eagles. Thank you all for listening to Countdown to Kickoff. I'm out. Fins up. Let's go.
Thank you for listening to the DolphinsTalk.com podcast. Be sure to visit DolphinsTalk.com every day for all of your latest Miami Dolphins news.